Not much. Okay, let's go back to our discussion of the wave that was traveling in the negative direction when I got cut off. Let's watch the wave propagating in the negative direction as it attenuates, something like this. It's attenuating with the same exponential curve, but this is the minus z direction. This is the plus z direction. What's happening is that this curve is e to the plus alpha z, which means the further negative I go, the smaller the wave gets. And the further positive I go, indeed, the bigger the wave gets. So I have these two equations, this one right here for a wave traveling in the positive direction, and this one for a wave traveling in the negative direction. The interesting effects that we see are when these two waves add up. That happens anytime we send a wave down a transmission line and it reflects off the end, which most often happens. In that case, our total voltage is going to be the sum of the two. Electromagnetic waves are linear. They simply add up. So it's V0 plus e to the minus alpha z e to the minus j beta z plus V0 minus e to the plus alpha z e to the plus j beta z. And this is a wave that has positive and negative propagation in the direction of travel. Now let's look at what the current would be. The current would have a very similar equation. It would be I0 plus e to the minus alpha z e to the minus j beta z plus I0 minus e to the plus alpha z e to the plus j beta z.